Can you tell me, can you reflect on it?
What white flight means and what happened here in Kansas City was it was almost 90 years of work of destroying the relationships between whites and blacks. And you had J.C. Nichols, who started developing properties south of Kansas City. Mm-hmm. And obviously, if you were going to develop these properties, you needed someone to buy them, right? So what happened was he came up with some racist regulations that were supported by the U.S. government and also the city and the county, where they began to divide the communities of color with the black folk. And so back in the early 1900s, you had wealthy folk, wealthy millionaires, you had business folk, you had blue-collar folk, and some poor folk living amongst each other. So what you see today wound up happening as we got segregated here in the city. They came up with some policies and some bad research that supposedly showed that people of color were not good folk to live next to. They didn't have good values. They would destroy the neighborhood and all kinds of bad research in magazines and data that was given to the general public. Thus then began the flight. White folk could get loans to move out, black folk couldn't. And so you began to, hyper-segregate communities. In Kansas City, where and those properties weren't available to people of color, and because they didn't want you,
right.
And so all of the properties south of Kansas City and around Kansas City began to be populated by whites who had better morals and better values than the rest of us, and so you had folk who couldn't move, and with that flight of residents, you then began to entice and move businesses. So all your laundry mats, all your dry cleaning, superstores, markets and whatnot began to leave as well. Banks even. Because then that hyper-segregation began to only fill the void with people with low-income jobs to moderate-income jobs. So if you knew a black folk was going to move next to you, you sold your house. So it's also called redlining, where you had realtors that would go around the neighborhoods. And they would go and tell you that I can give you so much money for your house right now, or your house is going to lose value when the black family is on its way.
And do you feel like, growing up as a child, did you witness any of that behavior in your community?
Yeah, I did, mainly when I was aware of it in probably the 80s and the 90s, when many of my friends who would go off to college and earn degrees. My own family did the same thing. It's their right. It's their right to buy a property or whatever, move over they want. It distressed me a bit because we professional Latinos, were buying back in our communities and fixing up the homes and investing in